Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hi, I'm Renee Kennedy. I'm from Melbourne, Australia. I live in a town, small town called Broadford, which is about an hour north of the Melbourne CBD, with a population of about 4,500. It's not a city style of town, it's more country, but very accessible to cities and very accessible to other states in my country. I judge under FCI rules and regulations in Australia because we are an associate to FCI, and I have had my judging license since November of 2016. Our Kennel Council runs a program in my state, which is Dogs Victoria, is the controlling canine body for purebred dogs. They run a program, and in a minimum of 2 years you may qualify to be a specialist in your breed, or you can choose to undertake the whole group. So in my country, the Rottweiler is part of what's called the utility group, which is around about 23 to 25, I think, different breeds. I chose only the Rottweiler because they're the only breed that I really have a passion for. I've shown many different breeds of dogs, but I don't care to judge them. My connection to the breed started off through my mum. She purchased a pedigree Rottweiler. She decided to have a go at showing, and of course, me being a child, I tagged along and was encouraged to have a go at showing dogs. So I was around about 9-10 years of age, and I started handling other breeds before I started handling Rottweilers, which was really helpful to learn more about Rottweilers through other breeds. And then when my mum bred her first litter, I was able to keep a puppy, and that puppy was the start of my passion for the breed. Kennel Club in my country is called the ANKC. In America, it's the AKC. That style of showing across the board is more popular, but the showing style, the preparation and conditioning on your dogs is completely different. In an AKC style show, first difference is the handler needs to dress really appropriately, more formal, suits, skirts, nice looking shoes, hair, makeup, depends how far you want to go. And unfortunately, that does detract sometimes from the dog itself. In Seeger style show, more important for the dogs to be conditioned for fitness, conditioned for long amounts of running, focus on toys or a handler more so than food. And they need to be able to last those long period of time running and then being pulled up and focusing. So it's pretty constant. The way you dress in an AKC style is supposed to be taken into consideration when judging the dog. It has absolutely no relevance in a Seeger style show.
Very good chest depth. Could have a little more width. Stands mostly straight in front.
AKC style showing, you get absolutely no justification or explanation for your placings. They do not grade your dogs. They do not talk to you about potential for your dog moving forward with breeding, or tell you what you could improve on. They don't tell you anything. It's very quick, it's very regimented. If you miss that opportunity that the judge looks at your dog and your dog isn't standing correctly, you've got no hope. Seeger show is much more free. The handler should be a post. It's all about the dog being on show. And the most important part of a Seeger style show is the double handling, because they are the ones that get the attention and the focus of your dog. It is up to the handler to be able to see from the back of the dog whether or not it's standing correctly, standing straight, or if it's focused or not focused. But your double handler is very important. You cannot have a double handler in an AKC style show. Actually, you can be banned for having someone call your dog from outside the ring. To undertake that judging program, in the first year, you're known as an aspiring judge. And that requires you to attend a group with a mentor leader who gives lectures and instruction and information regarding the basics of dogs' anatomy, including skeletal system, history of breeds, what they were bred to do, what they can and can't do. And then it also goes over your rules for being a judge. It teaches you etiquette for being a judge. It teaches you ring craft. If you pass your tests in your first year, the second year, you're known as a trainee judge. And a trainee judge has to undertake tests specifically on the breed. So then it really got down to my breed rather than worrying about everything else. So the mentor of the group held lectures on my breed, but I was asked to present information on my breed and comparisons and justifications to the standard. And then I was tested on that standard. And then my final test to become and pass as a judge, I had to judge a certain amount of females, a certain amount of males, and I had to choose a best of breed after an already qualified specialist judge had done so. If he wasn't happy with my judging and I couldn't justify my placings, I would not have passed. So we base the gradings on the dog, their top qualities versus their not so good qualities, okay? So if a dog has, say, more than four not so good qualities, it can't possibly be given an excellent rating, okay? If a dog has severe faults that aren't disqualifying, could be G-rated. If a dog has a missing tooth or an incorrect bite, I have to excuse the dog and disqualify it because it doesn't conform to the breed standard at all, because it's a serious fault and it should not be bred with. The reason why we eventually prefer to stick to Seeger style showing is because it's so much more knowledgeable than AKC style showing, and it gives you a purpose for wanting to take the breed further and do the right thing by the breed so you can ensure that there's good quality dogs. I unfortunately live in the only state in Australia where IPO style training isn't allowed because of our legislation. We are allowed to train for IPO style under licensed trainers, but we are not allowed to do it in public. And that's really unfortunate for the breed because our breed is unethically bred a lot. We don't have any trouble selling Rottweiler puppies in my country, but the amount of breeders that choose not to health test, that don't screen temperaments, that don't show, that don't do any work, and work I mean by IPO style training, agility, tracking, scent work, herding, they do nothing but breed for profit. They don't care about the health or the temperament of the dogs. That is a huge problem in my country. I think it's probably a worldwide problem. And the problem is that even though there are organisations with rules, ethics, people know they can still get away with selling the breed without having to be members of those organisations. And those organisations need to figure out how to encourage anybody with a purebred Rottweiler to join the club to benefit the breed. And we somehow need to start policing people doing the wrong thing, breeding Rottweilers. Otherwise, in my country especially, we are really at risk of having them banned from being owned. I encourage anyone that owns a Rottweiler to not only bring your children up with your dogs, but try and get your children interested in carrying on the breed for the right reasons.